Hello and welcome to another Blender tutorial. My name is Raymond Gabriel and today we will be learning how to create this eyeball rig in Blender. So without any further delay, let's get started. I will use this image for the tutorial. You can download it from a link in the description below. The problem with this texture is that it's in JPG format and its background is white and it's not alpha, it's not transparent, which will not work very well in Blender. So we will need to change the white background to an alpha channel. To do that, you have to open Gimp first or Photoshop. Now drag and drop the image inside of Gimp. First, let's check if this layer have an alpha channel. So go to layer, then transparency, then add alpha channel. Now, this image contains an alpha channel. All we need to do is remove the white color. So select the magic wand or fuzzy select tool, then go to the white color, select it, and it will select all the white color in the image. Now press Ctrl X, and that will remove the white color from the image and will leave the alpha channel behind. Press select, then none to remove the selection. Now press File, Export As, and save the image again. This time save it as PNG and not in JPG format, so the alpha channel is stored. Click export. Okay, now the texture is ready. Let's switch to Blender. In Blender, select everything and press X to delete the default objects. Press Shift A. From mesh, select UV sphere, and that will be the base of our eye. Press R, then X and 90, so we will have the circles in front. Now what we need to do is go to the corner of the viewport and split it into two parts. Switch this one to UV editor, where we can see our UVs. Now go to the front perspective and press 5 on your numpad to switch to orthographic, or from view you can switch to orthographic from this option. Now press tab to go to edit mode. As you can see here, the UV appeared. This is the default unwrapping of the sphere. We don't want it this way. We want to have the UV of the sphere to be exactly matching as in the viewport. So press U, and instead of using the normal unwrap method, go to project from view so we can project it exactly as we see it in the viewport. Now let's add the texture as a material. So go to the material tab, press new, rename the material to eye, go to corner here and split the viewport into two again. From here select shader editor, press N to close this panel if you want, press Shift A. From texture, image texture, and from here press open and go to where you save your PNG and open image. That will add the image inside of this node. Let's connect the color to the base color here. To be able to see the texture in the viewport, you have to be in the rendered shading. Right now you don't see it, so you can go to this ribbon and scroll, so you can scroll to these options and select viewport shading. That will switch the scene to viewport shading, but right now it's very dark because we don't have any light in the scene. First go to object mode, press Shift A and add light, sun, and that will add some lighting in the scene. Press Shift D to duplicate the sun. Now as you can see, the eye is not trapped correctly on the sphere. Press tab to go to edit mode. Now go to UV editor and select everything by pressing A. If you scale that up until you have the right scale of the eye, right now I think it's okay, but right now the texture is repeating itself, so let's fix that. You can do that simply by going to the image node here and instead of repeat select clip, and that will clip every repetition of the texture and you will see only this part. So right now we have the alpha appearing as black color, and we don't want that. We want it to be white, so we want to tell Blender that the alpha of this image is a white color. In order to do that, we have to duplicate this node to make another color node here. The default color is white. Now what we need to do is mix these two nodes, one with the image attached to it and one with the color, and mix them together using a mix shader. So press Shift A and go to Shader and select Mix Shader. Now select the output of this node and connect it to one of the shaders. Select the output of the other node and connect it here. After that, connect this output to the output of the material so you can see it in the viewport. Right now, as you can see, you have a factor of 0.5, meaning that this node is trying to mix 50% of this node and 50% of this node. If you change it to 0 completely, you will only be seeing this node. If you change it to 1, you will only be seeing the white color. What we need to do is change the factor to the alpha of this image. So simply connect the alpha output of the image into the factor, but right now it's inverted, so let's invert these two. And now we have the alpha appearing as white color, and anything but the alpha is appearing as the image texture that we have. Perfect. Now press right click and select shade smooth so you can see the object smoother. Now let's rig the eye. Press Shift A and select armature. That will add a bone to be able to see it inside the object. Go to this tab and from viewport display select in front, and that will make it visible even if it's inside the sphere. Now press R, then X and 90, so it's pointing outward. Now go to edit mode and select the bone. Press Shift D and Y to move it on the Y axis. Make sure that you are in edit mode so you don't accidentally create two armatures. Now go to viewport display and change the display as to B-bone. That will change the type of the bones. Now you can scale it on the Y axis and also scale it by pressing Ctrl Alt S, and that will scale it like that. And right now we want to do is make another bone inside of this one. Press Shift D and that will duplicate the bone. Press Escape to snap it at the same location of the duplicated bone. Now press Ctrl Alt S and scale it down so it is smaller than the outer bone. Now let's parent the bone inside to the outer bone. So select the inner bone first, then select the outer bone, press Ctrl P and then select Keep Offset. Now this bone is parented to the outer bone. Now let's adjust the model of the eyeball a bit. So go to object mode, select the eyeball, press tab to go to edit mode, go to the right orthographic view, then switch from here to wireframe, or press Z to get the menu and change it from here. Then press and drag, select all these vertices, go to the render shading, press S, then Y, then 0 to flatten this part out, press enter to confirm. Now press G, then Y, and move it backwards like that. The purpose of the smaller bone is that it will control the size of the cornea, and the outer bone will control the rotation of the eyeball itself, and it will be controlled by this bone. So right now what we need to do is rename all the bones so it will be easier to use them in the following steps. Press tab to go to edit bone, select the outer bone, then go to this tab from here, change it to IK. Now select the inner bone and call it maybe cornea underscore control. Select this bone and call it IK underscore control. While selecting this bone, go to this check mark and remove it. This will remove the deformation of this bone, and when it's attached to any mesh, it will not deform it. So when we go to this eyeball, then select the armature, then press Ctrl P and select with automatic weights. That will attach the eyeball to the bones, and when we go to this, then go to vertex group, you'll see that the vertex groups that are added are for these two bones only and not for this one. Now what we want to do is adjust the weights of these two bones so each bone affects the right part of the eye. Press Ctrl Tab and go to weight paint. You will see now that the IK is controlling the eyeball by 50%, which is the green color, and the cornea control is also affecting the eyeball with 50%. We need to change that and make the cornea control only affects this part and the IK affects everywhere else. To do that, go here and select vertex select. That will open up the vertices that are creating this mesh, and now we press A to select every vertex, and from here change the weight to 1, then assign. That will make the IK control the whole eyeball for now. Now press the cornea control and change the weight to 0, then press assign. What we need this bone to control is this part of the mesh. So press Alt A to deselect everything, press C for circle select, then press and select these circles, these vertices. Okay, press escape to get out of circle select, change the weight again to 1, then press assign. Now go to IK, change this to 0 and press assign. Now the IK is controlling everything but this part and the cornea is affecting only this part. Perfect. Now press here to remove the vertex selection, just control tab and go to object mode. Now what we need to do is add constraints to these bones so they are working correctly. Press control tab to go to pose mode, or from here switch to pose mode, select the outer bone, then go to this tab which is the constraints tab, press here and select inverse kinematics, and then from target select the armature, then the bone section here will appear, select IK control. That will make this bone control the behavior of this bone when this moves. This bone will be targeting it, and because the inner bone is parented to the outer bone, it's also following its movement. Press control tab to go to object mode. After that, select the inner bone, then add a constraint to it, copy scale, then from the target select armature and the bone, select IK control also. Now when we move it, it will move the whole eyeball, and then when we scale it, it will scale the cornea part, but as you can see it's scaling in all the directions, so we want to lock it on the y-axis. Press N to get the side panel here, go to this tab and from the scale press this lock behind the y-axis. Now when we scale, it will only scale on the z and x-axis. So right now what we need to do is duplicate what we have done so far and make two eyeballs instead of one. So select the armature, then press tab to go to edit mode, press G to move it, then press X to lock it on the x-axis. Now press 1.5 on your keyboard, then negative so you can move it in the negative direction, then press tab to go to object mode, select the eyeball itself, press tab to go to edit mode, press G, X, 1.5, negative, and that has moved the whole rig by 1.5 units in the negative direction. As you can see, we have moved in the edit mode, so the origin point is still in the center of the scene. So now if I go to the armature and press tab to go to edit mode, I can add the names of the bones, .l, all the names of the bones should have .l on it. Now if I selected everything, press right click and selected symmetrize, now the bones have symmetrized and duplicated itself to the other side, and now it's named .r. So let's do that for the eye itself. Press shift D to duplicate the eye. Now press control M so you can mirror. Press X to mirror it along the origin point, then press enter to confirm. But right now the problem is when I move this bone, the other eyeball is moving with it. So to fix that, go to object mode, select the eyeball, go to vertex group from this tab, and change these two vertex groups to the names of the new bones, which is ik.r instead of l. Now that should fix the problem. If I move this, this will move this eye and this will move this eye. Perfect. Now, to complete the eye rig, we need to make a controller to control these two bones. So go to edit mode by pressing tab, select this bone, press shift D and press X, write 1.5, press enter, go to this tab and change its name to main eye underscore control. Now select these two bones, then select the main control, press control P to parent it and select keep offset. Now if I go to pose mode and try to move it, these two bones will move with it. What if we want the eyeballs to not be exactly a sphere shaped but an oval shaped instead? We can just select the eyeballs and scale it on the z-axis like that, because that will make the animation a little bit weird, because the eyeballs might be extruding out of the character and you will probably not want that. So instead of doing that, press shift A and select lattice. That will add this cube. Go to the front orthographic, press Z and go to wireframe, press G then X and move it to the center of the sphere, then press S to scale it and move it up until it's surrounding the whole sphere. Make sure for all direction that it's surrounding the sphere. Now go to rendered view, select the eyeball, go to the modifiers tab and add lattice. From here select the lattice that you have created, and now when you select the lattice and press tab to go to edit mode, press A to select all the vertices. When you scale them, it will influence the mesh of the eyeball. So when you scale it on the x-axis and maybe scale it on the y-axis, we can have this oval shape and maybe scale it up like that. Now if I go to object mode, select the armature, go to pose mode, when I move the eye, it will be moving inside of the lattice and it will result in better animation for your characters. So to do that for the other eye, we can simply select the eyeball, select the one with the modifier, press Ctrl L and select modifier, and that will copy the lattice from here to the other eyeball as well. Now we have a perfectly working eye rig. I hope you found the video useful. If you did, don't forget to like, share and subscribe for more videos like this. Check out my last videos from these links. Thank you for watching and goodbye.